Hi guys, Michael Kinnerick, Movement is Life. It is Tuesday, and Tuesday is Double Tap Tuesday. But first, I want to congratulate the five people that earned their primer patch throughout the primer program, strength acquisition program here at the school. For the last 6 weeks, they did a strength acquisition program for stronger grip. Great results. Five people graduated, not including me. That would make six. And people were amazed at the results. So congratulations to everybody that got the primer patch. Okay, so today I want to talk about the double tap. Today is the two triangles of Haganah. Okay, in Haganah, there are two triangles that are related to baseline. Okay, your baseline is either active or dormant. Active means always ready. Something happens, you're ready to go. Dormant means you need notice. In other words, you're almost there, you train, but you let go a little bit, you're slacking, so you need a notice. Like 2 weeks from now, somebody's gonna attack you, you better be ready, so get your shit together. Always ready means active baseline. Dormant baseline means it's inside, but it's sleeping, and you need notice. Okay, so how do I manage that? Okay, I have two triangles that create a third image. Okay, so the first triangle is this triangle. At the top is activities. In this corner is recovery, and in this corner is fuel. I'll explain. The top is activities because it's the most important thing. Movement is life. What you do dictates your body. What you do dictates your mindset. What you do dictates what the fuck's going on. In other words, movement is life. What are your activities? Now, to us in Haganah, activities most of the time means combat fitness. Are you fit? Combat fit. Okay, there's a big difference between fit and combat fit. I'll give you an example. Like, you got people, and I have friends here in South Florida that are runners, and they're long distance runners, and they run marathons, and they run Ironmans, and this and that. They are better than me at running, but if I fucking punch them in the face, they ain't running anymore. Okay, they are fitness endurance athletes, but they're not combat fit. On the other hand of that, I have friends here that are power lifters, bodybuilders, and they can bench press 300 pounds, and their maximum rep of deadlift is like 500 pounds, and they got veins coming out of their freaking thighs. It's so fucking sexy. Not, but that's beside the point. Okay, so those guys are stronger than me, but if I kick them in the leg because they're walking around with so much inflammation in their body, they are so fragile and they break like this, okay? They are not combat fit. They can lift, but they're not combat fit. To us, combat fit means I'm ready for a fight at any given time. It doesn't matter what fight it is, and I'm ready for a battle. The difference between a fight and a battle is a fight is one event, one person. A battle is one little events, one after the other. You started in the parking lot, you're getting into this building, blah, blah. That's a battle, okay? Are you combat fit? Are you battle ready, fit for combat? Okay, so that's what I mean by that. Okay, that's activities, okay? Then you have the fuel. The fuel includes three things. One, what you eat and how you eat. Do you eat clean? Do you eat bread? Do you eat fried food? Do you eat like shit? Okay, for an example, I only eat one type of bread. Rye bread, because it doesn't spike your insulin. So unless there's rye bread around, I ain't eating bread. That's the way it is. If I go eat shawarma, I take the meat out of the shawarma with the fucking baba ganoush and with the freaking Israeli salad and eat it with a fork. I don't eat the bread, okay? So one, what you eat. Two, what you drink. Okay, a lot of people don't realize you drink a lot of calories without even you knowing. Okay, I have a nemesis. I have like a bad habit. Monster. I love the white monster. It fucking wakes me up. It is my coffee. I used to drink about 7 monsters a day. I'm not kidding you. 7 monsters a day. Then I dropped it down to 5 monsters a day. Then I dropped it down to 3 monsters a day. And now I'm down to 2 monsters a day, and my new goal with, I'm starting a program on October 8th, but I'll talk about this in a different YouTube, is to drop down to 1 monster a day, and that will be the one only in the morning as my coffee. Other than that monster, all day long, all I drink is water with lemon and 1 Celsius. Okay, 1 Celsius because it got the fizzy babalech, and I like the fizzy babalech, okay? You'll never see me drink soda. If I go out, I always order water with lemon, blah, blah, blah. So one, what you eat. Two, what you drink. Three, your supplements. Supplements, everybody's different. I'm not talking about this. It'll take me 15 minutes video just to talk about supplements, okay? Everybody's different, so I'm going to say supplements, okay? So that's the fuel. Then you got recovery. Recovery includes 2 things. The quality of your sleep and you being smart when you train hard and when you don't train hard, and you understanding when you're spiking up and when you're going down. For an example, yesterday I walked like a fucking zombie. I was like a retard, okay? I was walking around mentally drained from the weekend at Lockwoods with the combat boot camp, the commando boot camp, and physically my body was tired. So Monday is hell bells. Can't skip hell bells. You gotta have discipline, okay? So I did hell bells, and the guy showed up, and here comes Jamaica, and here comes Steve, and here comes freaking the Russian pastor, and they are fucking ready to go, and I'm exhausted. I'm just mentally and physically drained, okay? So what did I do? I told them, listen, guys, I'm the weakest guy in the room today. I'm going to work half the reps and half the weight. You guys grab the regular weight kettlebells. I'm going to grab half a weight kettlebells, and I'm going to do half the reps. So don't pay attention, because if you stop swinging, when I stop swinging, you're going to do half the workout. That's called recovery. That's called being smart. Okay, so that's the first triangle. The second triangle has to do with weapons and fighting. First, H2H. What is H2H? Hand-to-hand combat. What we Israeli call Krav Panim El Panim. In other words, fist fighting. How good are you with your hands? How good are you with your elbows? How good are you at clinching? Are you good at throwing or not let the other guy throw you? How good are you at ground survival or grappling in case the guy took you down to the ground and he's sinking you in? He's just sinking you in, and there's no way you're getting up. So you need to understand that method, okay? So that's H2H, what we call in Israel, Krav Panim El Panim, fist combat, in fist, motherfuckers, right? But then you have knives, okay? Knives in Haganah used to be ITK 1000, regular grip, ITK 2000, reverse grip. That's like vintage Haganah. When we first came out with the VHS videos, there was two videos, ITK 1000, Israeli Tactical Knife Fighting 1000, regular grip, ITK 2000, in VHS. Then it turned into DVDs, okay? So that originally, that was what the knife fighting was in Haganah. Then it became Blade Warriors because of all the contracts I was getting with the military, and I went to train the Raiders, and I trained to JTACs, and blah, blah, blah. And things have evolved, so Blade Warrior was created, and now we do Blade Warriors. And in Blade Warriors, there's also the trench fighting of knife fighting, okay? So that's all related to knives. Then you have firearms. In Haganah, firearms, you have handgun, you have Uzi, and you have Tavor. Used to be M4 and Glocks only. Okay, now you have Glocks, Uzi, and Tavor. Let me tell you something about fucking Uzis. This weekend, we did the Israeli Commando boot camp, and neither the Uzi or neither the Tavor was better or worse than the others. Half of the course did it with Uzi, and half of the course did it with Tavor, and everybody had a blast, and that Uzi is unbelievable. So, again, that's the firearms. Now, between this triangle, which has the activities, recovery, and fuel, and this triangle, which has the knives, the H2H, the hand-to-hand combat, and the firearms, it creates, ba-ba, this image. So those are the two triangles of Haganah, okay? So that's your baseline. That's the double tap for today, guys. It is Tuesday. Go get it. Gorgeous day down here in South Florida. Not this weekend. The next weekend is the Legacy Certification. There's a lot of people coming in from out of town. California, Texas, New Jersey, Pennsylvania. Can't wait for that. Movement is life. Keep moving. Be smart about how you're moving. I hope everybody's going to blast. I know I'm having a great fucking day. We had a great weekend with Israeli Combat Commando Boot Camp. People finished their Primal program last night. Go get it.